Long, long ago, a 17-year-old girl whose best friend had committed suicide told me, "Sir, nobody wants to die." I said, "Yes, but your friend did choose to die." She said, "No, nobody wants to die. It's just that when there is no other option, when life has nothing else to offer, a person commits suicide." That was an eye-opener. I think this was about 25 years back. And since then, I have been thinking of innumerable myths that surround suicide. The first one is that, believe me, 90% of humanity thinks that suicide is an act of cowardice. I have come across innumerable people, including doctors, nurses, policemen, relatives, telling a person who has attempted suicide and has survived that, "Why are you being a coward? Why are you running away? Why don't you face challenges? We all have problems. Why are you trying to run away from your problems?" Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, suicide is not an act of cowardice. It is an act of immense courage. It takes a lot of courage. Perhaps it takes more courage to kill yourself than it takes to kill somebody else. And if you have doubts in your mind, on your way back home today, just stop at a hardware shop and buy 3 meters or 4 meters of nice thick nylon rope. Go home, tell your people that you've got a headache and that you'd like to sleep and not to disturb you. Lock up your bedroom, pull the curtains so nobody can see you. Tie that rope to a fan or a ceiling. Make a noose. Make sure that the noose is at least 6 inches higher than your height. Climb on top of a chair. Put that noose on your neck. Remove it and come down. That's it. If you actually manage to do that, you will see how you are feeling at that moment. You didn't want to kill yourself, you just wanted to see what it feels like for a person who goes through this, right? Just to go through that little thing, it takes so much of courage. Imagine or visualize a person who actually says that, "Let me do this and kill myself." What goes on in that person's mind? Another great myth about suicide: people are impulsive. People just go ahead and kill themselves. The media actually encourages that sort of thinking. Here was this lady whose husband refused to take her to the movie theater, so she went and killed herself. Here was this girl whose boyfriend refused to talk to her and she went and committed suicide. These are all myths, let me tell you. Nobody commits suicide that way. 99% of people who have committed suicide or even attempted suicide have done so after immense and detailed planning. And the most important thing, why we are here today, they have given out signals. They have reached out. According to me, suicide is a cry for help. Every person who attempted or succeeded in suicide has given out that cry for help. We have not heard it. How did they do that? Some people actually said, "I'm fed up of life, I want to kill myself." Hey, don't be silly, man, come on, let's enjoy ourselves, come, let's go for a movie. There are people who have said, "Hey, listen, I borrowed that $100 from you, I don't want to leave anything pending, here's your $100 back." "Hey, what $100, man? I don't even remember what it was." No, I don't want to keep anything pending. I don't want to, you know, have due debts or something of that sort. Here's your 100 rupees back." Each one of these are signals, and every person who has committed suicide or attempted suicide has given that cry for help, has given signals. It's up to us how we would like to become more sensitive. Let us use this day today to start looking around at people, somebody who's got examination stress, somebody who has failed in an exam, somebody who has failed in a relationship, somebody who is depressed about something. Let's try to reach out to those people. And what do you need to do? You don't need to be a psychologist or a psychiatrist to reach out to such people. All you need to do is to give them a good listening ear. We are here to listen. Tell all your friends, tell all your relatives, tell all your neighbors, tell all your classmates, I am here to listen to you. Anything that you have to say, I am there with you. I can't do anything more than that, but I'm here to listen to you. Believe me, if all of us make up that purpose, that idea that we want to, you know, be listening to people, a vast majority of the suicides will be prevented. Why does a person commit suicide? When he becomes helpless, I can't help myself, I am no longer capable. Then he looks at hope. Is there hope that later in life something will change? When he says no, there's no hope, then he looks at whether he is worth it. If he feels he is worthless, there's no point in my continuing to live in this life, that is when a person decides, let me end everything. Before a person comes to that stage, if there's somebody who says, something will turn up, I don't know what, but I'm there to hold hands and walk with you this little journey, that's all that a person needs. And if you find that, if each one of us done that, we will not even come to know which suicides we have prevented, because if a person doesn't commit suicide, he's not going to go about telling everybody that I wanted to do it. But it will be the greatest gift that you have ever given to a friend, a classmate, a neighbor, a colleague, or whoever it may be. Let us make that resolution today and let us move forward to create a better life full of hope. Thank you very much.